Fuel up. Harness the power of your blender and cheat your way to good health. By Dana Cohen, MD, and Colin Sapire. This audiobook includes a supplemental PDF that includes recipes, resources, and recommendations, printable meal planning worksheets, endnotes, acknowledgments, and the About the Authors pages from the print edition. Dr. Dana. For my husband, Henry. Colin. For my family. Quick Start Guide. Establishing and sticking to healthy eating habits can be hard, so we are starting you off with two fuel-up habits that are good for you, easy to do, and can make a real difference in how you feel, all at the same time. They are the kind of simple things that will help you cheat your way to good health. Even if you continue no further, though we certainly hope you will, you can start feeling the benefits of fueling up right away by doing these two things. 1. Start your day with water. Drink a large glass of water when you wake up in the mornings, maybe with a squeeze of lemon juice and/or a pinch of salt. We'll explain why in the book. Do this before you consume anything else. 2. Enjoy a smoothie with benefits for breakfast. Designed as delicious and satisfying meals in themselves, our smoothie with benefits recipes are packed with a wide variety of nutrients and include protein, a healthy fat, and a generous dose of fiber. All the things you need to start your day feeling energized and fully fueled. Recipes can be found in the supplemental PDF, and there are plenty to choose from, so pick one that tantalizes your taste buds. Introduction. Healthy eating shouldn't be so hard. Healthy eating was always a challenge for Colin. He describes himself as a super taster, someone with a heightened sense of taste, which for him meant he grew up despising the taste of vegetables. This was particularly true of the bitter ones that are supposed to be so good for you. Broccoli, spinach, cauliflower, they all turned his stomach. Instead, his tastes ran more toward burgers and fries. He could plop down on the couch to watch television and polish off a whole box of cookies in one go, but a green salad? Not a chance. As Colin grew older, his need for better nutrition grew more important. His career as an entrepreneur was often hectic and demanding, and he found that he needed regular exercise to keep up with it all. To this day, if he doesn't sweat in the mornings, he just doesn't feel like he has the energy, outlook, or confidence he needs to be productive. He's also a longtime runner, and by the time he reached his 40s, he had found that burgers and cookies were no longer cutting it to fuel his runs. He began choking down a small salad before his usual dinner to provide at least some of the nutrients he'd been missing. But it just didn't feel like enough. It didn't feel practical or sustainable either, because he really didn't like that salad. This was a big part of what motivated Colin to develop the hugely popular Nutribullet blender, and more recently, the Beast blender, which launched in 2021. These were more than just business ventures for him. They were also ways to make the healthy foods he had been avoiding more palatable and easier to consume in larger quantities. Colin knew that to live the life he wanted to live and to feel the way he wanted to feel, he needed better fuel. He needed to find ways to consume all the healthy foods that would help him feel energized and alert on a daily basis, and that would help to stave off illness and disease in the long run. Colin started by making smoothies in his blender and sneaking in those less tasty but nutrient-rich ingredients with ones he enjoyed. Dates have always been a favorite, and they obscure the flavor of most greens. He experimented and found that foods like apples, citrus, and nut butters also did the trick. He now has a veggie-packed smoothie every morning, and that's in addition to enjoying, key to making this sustainable, other nutrient-rich blended recipes throughout the day, like soups, marinades for meat, and even desserts. He calls it cheating. his way of quickly, easily, and deliciously up-leveling the nutrition in his meals so he gets all the high-quality fuel he needs to be at his best. It has been a sustainable cheat, too. He has been eating like this for 15 years, and along the way, something interesting happened. He has become something of a veggie convert. He consumes, and even kind of likes, a greater variety of vegetables, the kind that used to turn his stomach. He even started an edible garden in his backyard that he picks from each morning for his blends. He still has a burger and fries sometimes, but that's just one part of an overall healthy eating pattern that works for him. Now in his 60s, he has never felt better in his life. Why we need to cheat. People often use the word cheat as a way of admonishing themselves or expressing guilt about the foods they have chosen. I was bad today. I cheated on my diet by having a donut. Or, today is my cheat day when I get to eat the things I actually like. We think that's a pretty disempowering way of thinking about food, so we would like to redefine the concept of cheating when it comes to what you eat. Instead of making you feel bad, we would like to turn it into a strategy that you can actually embrace. For us, a cheat is any tool or strategy that makes it easier, more satisfying, tastier, or more sustainable to eat healthier. That's because we all know that we should be eating healthy foods, but just because we know something doesn't mean it's easy to do. Colin's quest for better fuel led him to consider whether he was hydrating well enough to keep up with his active lifestyle and whether his blender could help. He met Dr. Dana when he contacted her about a book she had co-authored on the subject. Blending can be a great tool for staying hydrated, of course, but Dr. Dana was equally interested in how Colin was using it to uplevel his nutrition. As an integrative physician, Dr. Dana spends a lot of time talking with patients about what they eat, and she has witnessed the profound difference that healthier habits can make in their lives. She has also seen how confusing media messages and the persistent influence of diet culture have failed people. Early in her career, she worked for the famed Dr. Atkins, the first to popularize a high-protein, low-carb way of eating. And she saw firsthand how his and similar methods just don't work long-term. Too often, the focus is on weight loss over health. They are not one and the same. And the weight people do lose rarely stays off for long. In fact, these kinds of diets often lead to unhealthy patterns of gaining and losing, which obscures the true goal of healthy eating, which is to give our bodies the fuel they need to function well and feel good. What she really wanted for her patients, and for herself, was to find ways to help her patients eat better that actually worked for them, and not just for the duration of a diet, but over the course of their entire lives. Of course, that goal can be challenging for so many of us. As a culture, we have a complicated relationship with food. We have so much. Visit most grocery stores and you will find a dizzying array of options from around the globe. So many, in fact, that it can be mind-boggling to figure out what to buy. We consume so much to the point where, as we all know by now, a majority of Americans are classified as overweight or obese. And yet, despite all this abundance, most of us are actually undernourished. You heard that right. We still have widespread nutritional deficits in our culture. Consuming more and having more food options has simply not led to better nourishment or fuel in much of the Western world. Consider that just 10% of Americans eat enough vegetables to fully fuel themselves. Just 12% of Americans eat enough fruit to get all the nutrients they need. Just 1 in 20 Americans get the amount of fiber their bodies require. These statistics are pretty surprising when you think about it. We have so much in this country, and yet practically no one is getting everything they need from their food. And these kinds of deficits have real consequences. Our bodies are amazing machines. All on their own, they can ward off pathogens, clear toxins from our systems, heal our wounds, power us through our days, and more. But they need a continual supply of nutrients to perform these remarkable feats. For example, magnesium, which can be found in a wide variety of plant foods like seeds, nuts, grains, and leafy greens, is crucial for energy production and plays a key role in how our bodies handle stress. And yet, magnesium shortfalls are not uncommon. Another example is fiber, which is present in many fruits, whole grains, and legumes. It feeds our microbiome, which, as we are becoming increasingly aware, is linked to both our physical and our mental health. And yet, hardly anyone gets enough of it. We could provide 100 such examples. When left unchecked, being undernourished and underfueled leads to an increased risk of a host of chronic conditions, including diabetes and cardiovascular disease. There is evidence that nutrient deficits are contributing to the skyrocketing number of autoimmune diseases and nondescript and formal gut issues being diagnosed in so many people today. Research suggests that eating the recommended amounts of fruits and vegetables is associated with a reduced risk of everything from migraines to infections to eczema and more. It has even been estimated that 1 in 5 deaths across the globe is attributable to a less than optimal diet, more than any other risk factor, including tobacco. But this is about more than just disease prevention. It's also about how you feel on a daily basis, which is surely not at your best if you are.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.